Choice, Borgeois. epistle from the first and second epistle of Jesus, St. Peter, may his blessing do with us. Amen. Beloved, I now write to you the second epistle, on both of which I stir up your pure minds by way of reminder, that you may be mindful of the word which was spoken before by the holy prophets, and of the commandment of us, the apostles of the Lord and Savior. Knowing this first, that scoffers will come in the last days, walking according to their own lusts, and saying, where is the promise of his coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of the creation. For this they willfully forget that by the word of God the heavens were of old, and the earth, standing out of water and in water, by which the world that then existed perished, being flooded with water. But the heavens and the earth which now exist are kept in store by the same word, reserved for fire to the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men. But, beloved, do not forget this one thing, that with the Lord one day is 1,000 years, and 1,000 years is one day. The Lord is not as slack concerning his promise as some count slackness, but is long-suffering towards us, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. But that day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in which the heavens will pass away with a great noise, and the elements will melt with fervent heat. Both the earth and the works that are in it will be burnt up. Therefore, since all these things will be dissolved, what manner of persons ought you be in holy conduct and godliness, looking for and hastening the coming of the day of God, because of which the heavens will be dissolved, being on fire, and the elements will melt with fervent heat. Nevertheless, we, according to his promise, look for the new heavens and a new earth in which righteousness dwells. Therefore, beloved, looking forward to these things, be diligent to be found by him in peace, without spot or blameless, in account that our long-suffering of our Lord is salvation. As also our beloved brother Paul, according to his wisdom given to him, has written to you, as also in all his epistles, speaking them of these things, in which are some things hard to understand, which with those who are untaught and unstable twist to their own destruction, as they do also the rest of the scriptures. You therefore, beloved, since you know these things beforehand, beware lest you fall from your own steadfastness, being led away with the error of the wicked, but growing from the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be the glory both now and forever. Amen. Do not the world, nor things around the world. The Lord shall pass away, and all his desires be healed. Those who love God shall abide forever. Amen.
Are
not drunk as you suppose, since it is only the third hour of the day. But this is what was spoken by the prophet Joel. And it shall come to pass in the last days, says God, that I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your young men shall see visions. Your old women, your old men shall dream dreams. And on my men servants and on my maid servants, I will pour out my spirit in those days, and they shall prophesy. And I will show wonders in heaven above and signs in the earth beneath, blood and fire and vapor of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the coming of the great and notable day of the Lord. And it shall come to pass that whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. The word of the Lord shall grow, multiply, be mighty, and be confirmed in the Holy Church of God. Amen.
أعلموا يا أخوتي الأحباء أن اليوم هو الرابع من الشهر الصغير النسي. أحسن الله استقباله وعاد علينا وعليكم بكل هدوء وإطمئنان ورحمة وغفور الخطايا والأثام والزلات من قبل مراحم الرب. يا أبا يا أخوتي أمين. في مثل هذا اليوم بنايح القديس لباريوس أسقف روما رسم أيام الملك قسطاس ابن قسطنطين. ولما نفي أثناسيوس باب الإسكندرية وبولس بطريرك القسطنطينية حضر الإثنان عنده فأخذهما إلى الملك قسطاس الذي كتب الأخير فأرجعهما. وبعد أن قتل قسطاس في روما أرسل قسطنطينوس يطلب منه اتباع شريعة أريوس ويقبل نفي أثناسيوس فلم يوافقه على ذلك. فنفاه ثم أتى إلى روما وقتل قتيل أخيه. فقبله رؤساء الديورة والكهنة طلبوا منه رد أبيه من فاريوس فعاد من فاه وكان مداوما على الوعظ القوم أتباع أريوس إلى أثنيه السلام وأقام على كرسي 66 سنة. صلاة تقول معنا أمين. وفي هذا أيضا اليوم تنيح الأب القديس الناس كالأنبا كنا. وقد ولد نحو سنة 350 ميلاديا في إحدى بلاد مصر وكان له ستة إخوة يوحنا ويعقوب وأيوب ويوسف وسنسيس وإبراهيم. قد اتفق رأيهم على التراهم سبعة إخوات ولاد يروح يترهبوا في الزير فسكنوا في أحد الأماكن البعيدة وتركوا محبة العالم وحملوا لي المسيح وسلكوا في نص ذلك. واشتاقت أمهم مرة أن تراهم فأتت إليهم ووقفت من بعيد وأرسلت تدعوهم. فأرسلوا إليهم قائلين إنك لن تبصرين إلا في الظهر الآتي. عشان كده بيسموا الرهبان الموت الاختياري. هم خلاص ماتوا. فإحنا لما اللي بيموت بينتقل من العالم بنشوفه إمتى؟ لما نروح الله خلاص في السماء إن شاء الله مش فينا أخير. ففهمت جوابهم وانصرفت. ربنا كان بيدي الناس زمان إيه؟ فهم وبصيرة. جاية منين؟ من إيمان. محتاجين إيمان. اللي سنرمى في الظروف الصعبة دايما إيه؟ الإيمان. والإيمان هو الثقة بما والإيقان بأمور أنا مصدق اللي مش شايفه. لأن إحنا لو بس اعتمدنا على الحاجات اللي شايفينها فنحن أشقى جميع الناس. ففهمت جوابه وانصرفت. وكان الأب ديما مرشدا ومعزيا لشيوخ البرية وشبانها. وكان كل من اعتراه شيطان أو حدث به تجربة يأتي إليه فيشفيه. قد وضع هذا الأب تعليم كثيرا نفع منها قوله إذا رأيت أخاك قد أخطأ فلا تقطع رجاءه. بلنهض نفسه وعزيه وخفف ثقله عنه لينهض. إذا رأيت أخاك أخطأ فلا تقطع رجاله. يعني نظام إيه؟ يا عم أنت فيش منك فايدة. يا عم أنت ما مش عارف إيه. أنت عمرك ما تبطل اللي أنت فيه ده. بلاش الكلام ده. بلاش تقول على حد إيه؟ هما كده. هما عمرهم ما يتغيروا. أنا أعرف فلان دي أو فلانة دي بقالي 20 سنة. هم كده شكلهم كده تصرفاتهم كده عمرهم ما تغيروا. إذا رأيت أخاك قد أخطأ فلا تقطع رجاءه ولا تفقد رجاءك أنت كمان في خلاص نفسك. وقال علم قلبك ما يقول لسانك. وقال له أخ إذا رأيت أخا سيء استيره فإني لا أرتاح إلى إدخال قلاياتي، أما إذا كان حسن السيرة فإني أدخل فرحا. أجاب القديس: إذا صنعت مع حسن السيرة صلاحا فاصنع مع السيء أضعاف ذلك، لأنه مريض ويحتاج إلى الدواء. كثير أنا بتكلم عن نفسي، كثير أعرف الموضوع كويس، كويس أكلمه وصاحبه وقابله كويس وعامله كويس فرحا، لكن الإنسان المتعب حط فيش وش في الأرض وإيه وامشي. فبيقول لك إذا كنت بتعمل مع كويس صلاحا فاصنع مع الوحش إيه؟ أضعاف ما تفعله مع الكويس. ليه؟ لأنه مريض يحتاج إلى دواء، مريض يحتاج إلى دواء. اللي بيغلط ده إنسان إيه؟ مريض. اللي بيتعصب ده إنسان إيه؟ مريض. اللي ما بيعرفش يحب ده إنسان إيه؟ مريض. اللي ما بيعرفش يضبط لسانه ده إنسان إيه؟ مريض. اللي عينيه مش مفتوحة على العبادية ده وشيطان الطمع والحقد والكراهية ملكه ده إيه؟ مريض. ومريض محتاج إيه؟ دواء. لما يكون حد عيان مش بنتعاطف معاه ونروح نزوره في المستشفى ونجيب له هدايا مش كده؟ ونقعد جنبه نشوف محتاج إيه أكل نجيبه له، محتاج إيه شرب نجيبه له. هقولها تاني: إذا صنعت مع حسن السيرة صلاحا فاصنع مع السيء أضعاف ذلك، لأنه مريض يحتاج إلى دواء. ثم قال له: كان راهب بدير تيموثاوس قد وضع وقع في زلة وكان مدوما عن البكاء والطلب قائلا: يا رب أخطأ فاغفر لي. فأتاه صوت: إنني لم أتخلى عنك، إنني لم أتخلى عنك إلا لأنك تغفلت عن فيك في وقت محنتك. إنني لم أتخلى، ربنا قال له أنا ما تخليتش عنك غير لأنك تخليت عن أخوك وقت إيه؟ محنة. وأضاف قائلا: إذا سترنا خطايا إخواتنا فإن الله يستر خطايانا، وإذا شهرناها فهكذا يصنع الله معنا. إذا سترنا خطايا إخواتنا فإن الله أيضا يستر خطايانا، وإذا كشفناها هكذا يصنع الله معنا. وبعد أن أكمل هذا القديس أيامه بسلام تنيح وشكوك صالحة مرضية صلاته تكون معنا أمين. وامبارح كنا بنحتفل بتذكار رئيس الملائكة رافائيل، ملاك الله الشافي، وكلمة رافائيل معناها شفاء الله أو الله يشفي، وهو شفيع المرضى وشفيع المسافرين وشفيع الملاحين والدكاترة وأخصائي العيون والناس اللي بيطلبوا حياة زوجية سعيدة. والكنيسة بتعيد له عيدين، عيد في سبتمبر 8 سبتمبر وعيد في 22 ديسمبر. بركة صلاة هذا أو شفاعات هذا الملاك الجليل، والكل يكون معانا ربنا المجد يا رب.
Oh.
all of our teacher David the prophet and king, may his blessings be with us all. Amen. Your years are throughout all generations. In the beginning, you, Lord, did lay the foundation of the earth, and the heavens are the work of your hand. They shall perish, but you some day of the month of Nisan, as it's what we call it the short month. Sometimes comes 5 days, and sometimes comes 6 days, and sometimes even we don't have Sundays in this month. So this year we have a Sunday, so this is the one and only Sunday on this short month. And you know that the Coptic calendar is divided into 13 months. 12 months equal, so 30 days each. And then we have the 13 months, sometimes 5 days and sometimes 6 days. And this is the last month of the year. And today is the fourth day of this month, and it's only 5 days this year, so we have only 1 day left for the new year to come, the new Coptic calendar. That's why the feast of Nowruz, the Coptic New Year, will be on Tuesday. Today is Sunday. And the church, as a wise mother, try to remind its children every day and every time, be careful, the day will come, and the life on this earth will pass. Be ready, and don't be deceived. Last Sunday, we were having the life, the human timeline. You remember that? I don't know if you remember or not. We said that we have, it's like array, has a start point, but it has no end. And from the beginning, when we created, God created Adam and Eve to be eternal creatures. So He created us to live with Him forever. Okay? And earth was not the place that was designed from the beginning to live in. We are not from the earth. Okay? In the beginning, Adam and Eve were living in paradise. So we have been created to live with God in paradise in a heavenly life. Because of sin and the deceit of the devil, we were exalted from the paradise to this land, to the earth. So it is a land of cursing. Cursed is the land because of you. This is how God told Adam. So, and instead of joy and peace and purity and happiness and whatever we have or we had in paradise, we start to have suffering and illness and struggling and sadness and whatever in this sorrowful land and horrible land. But because of God's love and God's mercy, He did not leave us in this land with no hope, but He gave us a promise of a Savior that will come and save us and return us back to the paradise, return us back to the life of joy, the life of purity, the life of peace, the life of righteousness. And all the generations, starting from Adam, were looking for the saviors to save them from this present. That's why David in the Psalm said, "Set my soul free from the present. I want to take off from this world. I want to depart from this world and from this body. I want to be free again. I want to be joyful again. I want to be pure again." And in the fullness of time, God sent us His only begotten Son and was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and from Saint Mary and took the form of man to fulfill the characteristic of the Savior, 4 characteristics. You remember it? A human being with no sin, unlimited, and able to regenerate the corrupted nature. Because in heaven, nothing is corrupted. So the corrupted nature cannot inherit the incorruptible. The corrupted cannot inherit the incorrupted. So our nature has to be changed to incorrupted nature that we may live in heaven. This place which is not corrupted. And it changed the mortal to be immortal. And the perishable to be imperishable. Wow. Who is that? Who is that Savior? A human being with no sin, unlimited, and able to regenerate and renew our nature. He is God, our Lord, God and Savior, Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. God and man at the same time. As a man, He will offer Himself as an acceptable sacrifice on our sins. And as God, He is unlimited, without blemish. And as a Creator, He is able to regenerate our nature one more time to be uncorrupted. That's why we have a starting point and we have no end. We have a date of birth on earth and we spend a very short time on earth, maybe 100 years, maybe less, maybe more. And after this very, very, very short time compared to the eternal life, we're going to pass away from this world and stay in a waiting area until the second coming of Christ, the day of judgment, where He will judge the living and the dead. And then we'll have a group in His right hand and a group in His left hand. Whoever at His right hand will go to eternal life, and whoever is in left hand will go to eternal punishment, God forbid. So this is a fact that we will live forever. We will have eternal life or eternal punishment. Pascal, he was a great French scientist in the year 1623. He said, either God exists or He does not exist. And we can't use reason to determine which alternative is true. 50-50. However, both our present and our future lives may be affected by the alternative we choose. Either we choose God does exist, God does not exist. I'm telling this not because of you. I know that all of you are believers. But I want you to be able to defend your faith. If somebody told you, eternal life, are you crazy? No eternal life. This and that said, no, there is eternal life. God promises with that. God? Do you believe that there are even God? What is God? Don't believe in God. So tell him the same story of Pascal. Tell him that God is exist or not exist, it's 50-50 probability. We can't reason it. We can't determine it. Okay? However, whatever we choose will affect our life and our eternal life. Since the choosing to believe that God exists may lead to eternal life and happiness, and if it's false, then you stand to lose only a limited amount of well-being by accepting it. Therefore, the odds make deciding to become Christian. Where is the greatest threat here? If you choose God does not exist. But if you choose God does exist, and you believe in Him, and you listen to Him, and you obey to Him, you will live in honesty. You may lose some privileges in life, but that's it for 100 years. But then we will have eternal life. If you said that God does not exist, you may have some pleasures in life, but then we'll have eternal punishment. So the insurance, the only insurance to go to the kingdom of heaven is to believe in our Lord Jesus Christ. Most assuredly I say to you, he who hears my words and believes in Him who sent me has everlasting life and shall not come into judgment, but has passed from death into life. He who hears and believes has everlasting life and shall not come into judgment, but has passed from death into life. He who believes in the Son has everlasting life, and he who does not believe the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abides on him. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life, everlasting life. This is the only way. Are you agree or not? Unfortunate, in a youth retreat, Christian Orthodox youth, there were like a survey. Do you believe that Jesus is the only way to be saved or to go to eternal life, or there is other ways? Survey was for 100 youth. What do you think? What was the result? He's the only savior? Thank you. 30% out of 100 youth said Jesus is the only way. It's scary. He is the only way. It's not by good deeds. We are all sinners. We need a savior. The only way to be saved is through the blood of Christ. That's why we encourage our kids and our youth and everybody, come and partake of his body and his blood. Why? Salvation, remission of sins, and eternal life. Do you believe? We all say, yes, amen, 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 I believe. Yes or no? At the end of the liturgy, 3 times, yes, amen, I believe, yes. This is the only way. Do you have any other way than him? No way. There is no way away from Christ. There is no way. He is our Savior. He is our advocate. The one who is going to defend us in front of God the Father. The everlasting sacrifice of our Lord Jesus Christ. That's why we call everybody to come to the church and partake of this sacrifice. Because through this sacrifice only, we will be saved. Through the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. And upon at the end of the liturgy, hold it and say, amen, 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 I believe, I believe, I believe, and confess to the last breath, this is the life-given flesh that your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior, took from St. Mary, given for us for salvation, remission of sins, and eternal life to those who partake of it. Amen. I believe, I believe, I believe. This is the only way. Christ is the only way. And the sacrifice of the cross, his body and his blood, is the only way to be saved and to ensure eternal life. Yesterday, we had a ceremony, funeral service of one of our beloved youth, Yusuf Farid. It was a great ceremony. Everyone was here, everyone was. I don't know what was your feeling. Maybe we focused only that we lost him and we forgot that he gained eternal life. He gained rest. He gained peace. He gained purity. He gained righteousness through Christ. The one who believes it and lives carrying his name. And at the funeral service was Abuna Lua Sadros. And he gave us a very comforting message that no one without sin, even though his life on earth be a single day, who can say that I may pass even a day without sinning? Who can do that? And the wages of sin is death. We need Savior. We need Redeemer. We need someone to redeem our sins with His righteousness. Change. Who is that? Do you know anyone but Him? The Savior of us all. We are all sinners. We are all not worthy of the kingdom of heaven. We all. Even Saint Mary, the most pure person in the whole world, she said, "My soul rejoices in God, my Savior." So Saint Mary, the most pure person in the human race, from Adam to the end of all generation, she said, "I need Savior. I can't be saved without Him." How about me? There is no other way but Him. And in Him is our hope. Not because we are good. No. We are not good. But He is covering us with His righteousness. He is covering us. He is covering us with His love. To look nice in front of God the Father. To be able to inherit the kingdom of heaven. There is no other way but the sacrifice of our Lord Jesus Christ on the cross. That's why we keep saying in the liturgy, "Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, forgive us our sins. According to your mercy, O Lord, not according to our sins." Because we know that we are not worthy even to partake of His holy sacrifice. But what can I do as a sinner? Say sorry. Say sorry. Hard? Easy? Can we say sorry? Can we take this advantage of the liturgy and being in the presence of God and say, "Oh my Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy on me, a sinner"? You remember the publican who bent his chest and said, "Oh God, forgive me, a sinner, and have mercy on me"? What happened to him? He was saved. Because he repented. I can't be better. I can't be good with myself. I need help. I need grace. I need strength from above. Don't deceive yourself. Don't deceive yourself. We can't be better than that if you're alone. You need help. You need grace. You need salvation. And this you can't get it anyway but at the end of the year, and the end of every day, I may say all the time, "Let us offer repentance and confess our belief and our faith in our Lord Jesus Christ." That's why one of the best prayers you can pray with all the time, "Oh my Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy on me, a sinner." Oh my Lord, say with me, "Oh my Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy on me, a sinner." Oh my Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy on me, a sinner. Oh my Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy on me, a sinner. Oh my Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy on me, a sinner. Oh my Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy on me, a sinner. O my Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy on me, a sinner. This short prayer, is it easy or hard? Easy to remember? Can we pray with it all the time? All the time, but many times. Many times. 10, 20, 30. In this short prayer, we confess our belief that He is our Lord, God and Savior, Son of the living God, and He is the only Savior. Forgive me, a sinner. So we confess our belief. We offer repentance. Forgive me, a sinner. And we receive blessings. Very short, powerful prayer. Ya Rabbi Yesu al-Masih, Ibn Allah al-Hayy, arhamni, al-Masih. Ya Rabbi Yesu al-Masih, Ibn Allah al-Hayy, arhamni, al-Masih. Ya Rabbi Yesu al-Masih, Ibn Allah al-Hayy, arhamni, al-Masih. Ya Rabbi Yesu al-Masih, Ibn Allah al-Hayy, arhamni, al-Masih. Ya Rabbi Yesu al-Masih, Ibn Allah al-Hayy, arhamni, al-Masih. سهلة ولا صعبة؟ دي اللي احنا عايزينها منكم في السنه دي. صعبه؟ ها؟ تقول لي ما بعرفش اشوف الاجبيه يا ابونا، ما بشوفش المزامير، عقلي بيتوه، ما بقتش افتكر. صعبه دي ولا سهله؟ يا رب يسوع المسيح، ابن الله الحي، ارحمني. النهارده كان في ايه جميله جدا في سفر اعمال الرسل، يقول كده: لان كل من يدعو باسم الرب، يا رب يسوع المسيح ابن الله الحي، ارحمني. يا رب، ايه رايكم في الايه الحلوه دي؟ امسكوا فيها، قولوا: يا رب انا لا عارف اصلي عدل، ولا عارف اصوم عدل، ولا عارف احب الناس، ولا عارف اعمل حاجه عدله في حياتي، بس انا همسك في الايه اللي بتقول كل من يدعو باسم الرب ايه يخلص. وهقعد طول اليوم اقول لك: يا رب يسوع المسيح ايه، ارحمني انا خالص. يا رب يسوع مسيح عيني، أشكرك يا رب يسوع، يا رب يسوع، يا رب يسوع، يا رب يسوع طول النهار. وكل من يدعو باسم الرب إيه؟ يخلص. Whoever called in the name of the Lord will be saved. Oh my Lord Jesus Christ, oh my Lord Jesus Christ. The whole day you will be saved. Because you confess your belief in Him. You call Him all the day, you will feel His presence, and you will get a lot of blessings. Easy or hard? Easy. We can do it at school. We can do it in our way to work. The first thing when we wake up, before we sleep, every time, whenever we figure out that we did something wrong, oh my Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy on me. Don't let anyone shake your faith in your Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, because He is our Savior and He is our Advocate. Without Him, there is no salvation. Without Him, there is no eternal life. Encourage one another. He is very merciful. He is very generous. He is waiting for us all to be with Him. He is long-suffering. So encourage one another and love one another and call the name of the Lord all the time. Oh my Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy on me, a sinner. And use this holy time of the liturgy to offer repentance and ask for help. And glory be to God forever.
Oh, Oh,
by whom you have created all things, visible and invisible, who sits upon the throne of his glory, and who is worshipped by all the holy powers.
You who are seated, stand
before whom stand the angels, archangels, the principalities, the authority, the thorns, the dominions, and the
Oh. Lord. resurrection from the dead, the ascension into the heavens. He sitteth at the right hand of the Father, and his second coming from the heavens, O Son, full of glory. We offer unto you your gift, what is yours, for everything concerning everything and in everything.
Worship God in fear and trembling.
In Ozer of Tenez, Moer of Ten, Chem Chiem, O Ten, O Shem, O
holy prayer.
اجد لي للسلف صلاحا من اجل فقراء شعبان، من اجل الارملة واليتيم والغريب والضيف، ومن اجلنا كلنا نحن الذين نرجو ونطلب اسمك القدوس. لنا عين الكل تتركك، انت الذي تعطيهم طعاما في حين حسن، اصنع معنا حسب صلاحك المعطي طعاما لكل ذي جسد. املا لبنا فرحا ونعيما لكي ما يكون لنا الكفاية في كل شيء كل حين نزداد في كل عمل صادق.
Which is good, the poor.
don't let him to make us worthy of the communion and partake of his divine and immortal
mystery.
Through the coming down of Remember, O Lord, our sinless sins.
Save the only one to spirit in the fear of God, our sins.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
تلميتت انت في زمعه وطيرين انت الطوبو انني انت طالت شو اني شو انت لنفسي شنن السماوات القائم أمام علم ألوئيل
دايما في كل الأوبار تملو رحمة وعزة مبرح قلوب الهدى تامت رتب السماء محبوب من الشهداء
اسمك رفائل تفسير شفاء
Oh, yeah, cool.
أمام ملك هذه السريعة طار الوبائل تسبح سكرنا أمام الرب ليقبل لنا خطايانا وسبح مع ملك القائلين
مجد الله في العالي الأرض السلام ناس المصانع
آمين الإلهي
Yeah, I don't know.